Hello everyone, today we are going to see how to create a controller using 555 timer which is pulse width modulation based using Proteus simulation. Let us first see the components required. First we will need a 555 which is a 555 timer in instable mode because in instable mode the output is constantly shifting between output high and output low. Next we will require a resistor RES. We will require two resistors of 1 kilo ohm resistance which will be used in the 555 timer in instable configuration. Next we are going to use a potentiometer or POTG. This acts as a potentiometer of 100 kilo ohms that adjusts the duty cycle of the output voltage of the 555 timer. Next we need a diode IN4007 to prevent the backward flow of current. Next we are going to need capacitor, two capacitors of value 100 microfarad in the instable configuration of 555 timer. Next we will need a transistor 2N1711. This transistor acts to prevent the flow of excess current through the load so as to not to damage the load. Next we will need a LED green which acts as a green LED to visibly show the output of the instable mode of 555 timer. Next we will need a motor and fan DC. These two act as a load whose speed has to be controlled by adjusting the duty cycle of the 555 timer. Now let us first understand what is the instable mode of a 555 timer and what is the output. So the instable mode of the 555 circuit which can be seen here is the instable mode configuration of 555 timer. So in this mode there is not one single stable state or monostable state. The stable state is constantly shifting, or the output is constantly shifting between high and low outputs. So if we run, here we can see that, as you can see here, this is the output of the 555 timer in instable configuration, this blue line. As you can see, there is not one stable state. The stable state is constantly shifting between low and high. And that blue line is the expanded version of the instable state of the 555 timer. So as you can see here the output was high and then the output got low. As we will keep on going further, we will see that the output again gets high. The output here gets high. So this cycle will keep on continuing in the instable mode of 555 timer. Now what is pulse width modulation or PWM? In PWM we adjust the width of the pulse, that is this width, so that the average voltage of the pulse can be changed. So if we run it again and if I adjust it using this potentiometer, you can see the width of the pulse is changing. Now this is pulse width modulation, as we are adjusting the width of the pulse of this waveform. So let us suppose that in this stage the average voltage of the pulse is, let's say, 2.5 volts. Now if I increase the width, now and we can say that the output is like 5 volts or 4 volts, because the width has increased, hence the average voltage has increased. And now if I completely decrease the pulse width, now we can say that the output is, you know, close to 0 volts. Average voltage output is close to 0 volt. Now this is pulse width modulation, and using this we are controlling the speed or, you know, the output by controlling the average output voltage. As you can see here, this is the motor. The motor is rotating when the pulse width, when the resistance is low. This is when the pulse width has zero width. When the average output is zero, the motor is not rotating, and this motor is rotating due to inertia. Now, and the LED is also not playing. Now, if I increase the pulse, you can see the LED has started glowing according to the frequency of the pulse, and this motor has also started rotating, and the RPM of this motor is also increased. Now if I keep on increasing the width of the pulse, The speed of the motor increases. The LED is now completely glowing, showing the LED is now glowing for a longer period of time, showing that the average voltage is more and the speed of the motor is also increased. Now, if I completely increase it, the LED will glow continuously and the motor will also rotate continuously. The speed of the motor has increased because the average voltage input to the motor has increased. This is what is pulse width modulation. Thank you.